Oh, what's up, people? Yeah, a little action. That's right, September 9th. Just tearing it up. Getting my butt kicked. Nothing new. No, it was, man, I'm not disappointed at all. I think now looking back at it, since I'm back at camp, getting the clothes dried up now. Still raining. I knew going when we found those elk, I knew it was going to be a challenge because I've been over there before, and from there it's pretty much just straight up. And like I said before, I'm never that good of going up. I'm usually better at dropping in on them. But regardless, got to try. So, but yeah, and I tried in the video too. I don't know if you guys caught that, but I slowed it down a little bit. There was actually two calves and a cow that ran in the lake, right? Because I heard water, and I'm like, what the heck is that? And I'm looking through the timber, and I can see these three elk there, and then they finally bust out of there. They did not come from where those bulls were. Those were a whole different set of elk. They came out of the further side drainage, and then they went back up that drainage. I don't know if something spooked them. I don't know. I couldn't. Unless the weather, they just wanted to go play. I have no idea, but so we get across that clearing, and that bull sounded like he was bugling and leave, or what did some people call it, like bugle and run. That's not that is not what they do. What they're, you know, by the time we got up there, he was heading back up to his bedroom. When I got back and I actually looked on the Onyx, there was actually a really nice bench back up in there. It's real thick timber. So I'm guessing that's where he's at, because I didn't blow him out of there. I didn't know where the other elk was at that time, though, just because he was the only one making noise. Well, and my strategy was to, so he went this way, up, and then over on this bench. I knew there was another bench where those cows went, so I went that way. But that initial up, I actually ran into that other bull. He was like 70 yards in the timber, and I had all sorts of issues going on. With all the excitement, I thought I was turning the GoPro on, was actually shutting it off, and vice versa. So that was great. Because by the time I got focused on him, because I saw his butt, I'm like, I almost didn't even realize that was a elk butt at first. I just had a double take, and then I was like, well, I'll turn the GoPro on real quick. And you could see his little, I mean, I don't know, maybe a 3-point, if that. And he didn't really bust out of there. When I got back on camera, I think that was a bark. I think that's what he was doing, is barking at us, but because he's such a young bull, I was like, that was cute. So, but I still ended up going that way, though. I still kept what I wanted to do because the way the thermals were heading straight up, I actually did have this weird wind going that way. So I wanted to get away from that bull because I know where he's at. And I would like to go back at him, but just not going to do it tonight because the further I was heading up, the worse the fog was getting, and it started snowing. I could only see like 30 yards in front of me. And then by the time I dropped down and came back out of there, I started seeing, you know, up to 300 yards. But the higher elevations, I couldn't see anything. And then the weather's still here, so I doubt it's gonna be any better by the time I get over there this evening, so. My plan going forward is I will just hunt on the bottom end, and there's a couple little other spots I haven't hit yet, and I want to try them out. I've actually never hit them. I've heard, like, looking at the map, I don't know. It's going to either be good or it's going to suck. But at least I can see. And I didn't bust that bull out, so I'm pretty happy about that. But yeah, there's a lot of sign going on. There's a lot of movement. There's a lot of activity going on, so we're going to get after it this evening. Just kind of stay around this lower 9,100 feet instead of being up at 10,101 is where I hit one spot. I was at 10,2. So, yeah, we'll stay away from that just so I can. God, it was so good though, guys. That was good. I mean, it's September 9th. And real quick, I don't mean to drag these videos on forever, but I did hear, there's always this debate, especially on like elk forums and stuff like that, about when to call, how to call, how much calling should you do, how much, you know, should you be conservative, should you not call at all, it's early. if you're watching this video and you watched last season and you watched this season, it is September 9th. September 2nd, we had a chuckle. September 9th, we had a full-on bugle. You do the math. And you can tell I wasn't too crazy. I started really pushing that envelope, but I didn't go over the top. You know, I let him bugle before I did. I didn't try to force him to bugle. So, just, you know, biggest tip, just learn how to do it. And then, you know, play it by ear. I've always, when in doubt, copy them. If they're bugling, you go ahead, bugle. You know, get that location bugle on. If he responds, wait, you know, like we did. We waited until he bugled again. And then after that, it was my turn. I kept behind his tempo. So, yeah, I did try doing some more challenging bugles on him. I was trying to pull him out. I knew he was going to start heading up. So I tried to, like, was trying to hang him up so he didn't go all the way up. But he didn't care. So he was pretty happy on leaving. So, but it don't matter. I'm having such a good time. So, yeah, we'll actually get dressed right now. And we'll probably, since I already got something in my stomach, we'll probably go ahead and see if we can't get some midday action. I think if I could fire up a bull by 3, because it's 2:10 now. So if I can get a bull fired up by 3:30, I'd be pretty happy. That's my favorite, is midday madness, because a lot of people, this is when they're at camp. You know, usually I'm not, but I was getting a little wet, a little cold, and yeah. When in doubt, go dry off. Start again. So, all right, boys and girls. Day is young. Let's go get some.
Yeah. so thick right there. It just wouldn't come out right there. Which, that's the hang up. That part right there is where you need that shooter collar set up. Oh well. Man, I'm having a good time. This weather got him a little active, so. I think it must be a little raghorn and or a count of gaff. Because as soon as I got, I let him, I just kind of hung out there forever. It was about 10, 20 minutes. And finally he barked again, and it was further in, like a couple hundred yards. So I figured I'd close that distance, and then as soon as I got around the corner, I'm like, ah, crap. Count calf just hanging out there. Oh well. Man. I got time. No worries.
Alright. Well. 2.5 miles later. Got a whole nother pocket of drainages. Let's go see what's in there. Yeah. That sucked. I thought it was for sure. I was full of draw for a second. I kept hearing twigs break. I thought he was getting closer, but I think it was those cows. Like cow and calf, because he barked a lot further away than that previous one, so I guess I would have stuck a cow if it would have showed its face. That stuff was thick down there, though. He actually ended up putting my bow in my pack just so I can crawl through these willows. Insane. Alright. On to the next set of drainages. Here we go. Check this out. Whole fog's coming back. There's that. Look how gorgeous this is, though. It's pretty cool down here. I've never been down here. Let's get it.
What's up, peeps? Man, what's some action? We're getting there. Woo! It's tough, but we're... Oh, man. The stars have not quite aligned yet, but I feel like they are getting close. Now I'm getting the setup set up. The only thing I've noticed, I looked at some footage today from this morning. The way I'm setting up on some of these elk, I'm still doing it as a two-person team, a collar-shooter combo. And I got to get that in my head that that's not, you know, I started to do solo, and then out of nowhere, I'm just reactions kick in and I start calling and I'm like right there. So they all get hung up like that one bull, that last bull we saw. I don't know I'm going to see if the camera picked it up, but he was at 80 yards. I'm like, ugh, just right there. I mean, I drew once on the first bull. He just never really came through the window. So, oh well. Good times. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. I really appreciate you guys following along. And again, like, subscribe, share. It's gonna get your guys' name in a hat to win a bundle package. And it's gonna have, I haven't quite decided yet, but I'm pretty sure we're gonna have a brand new set of broadheads, probably some game bags, and then there's a bonus with that. With that, I also need to know how many hats I wear through this season. At all the episodes, how many different hats do I wear through the season? Yeah, and there'll be a little special treat there. That one's a good one. So I will, if you guys, if there's a tie, a couple ties, what I'll do is I'll put your guys' name in a hat and then I'll draw. But heading off the mountain, gonna get refueled. We're gonna get to the bow shed, get everything cleaned up. Wife's fridge shopping, so I'm gonna help her out and get whatever she picks. I'll get that installed. You know, you gotta do stuff like that so you can come back up here and enjoy these great outdoors and pursue the Wapiti. Again, big thanks, guys. I'll catch you guys on the next episode. We're getting in them. We're getting in them.